Kate Shapira, followed by Claire Miller.
Hello, my name is Kate Shapira. That's how it's pronounced.
I live on
Brighton Street, Providence. I want to speak to some of the hazardous waste-related discharge regulations that are in the DEM materials, which state that water quality standards are intended to protect public health, safety, and welfare. This is a quote. Enhance the quality of water and serve the purposes of the Clean Water Act. At a minimum, all water shall be free of pollutants in concentrations from anthropogenic activities subject to those regulations that adversely affect human health. In other words, and I know that you know this because this is your job, and please tell me if I'm speaking too fast. I have a tendency to do that, and I'm allowed to get through
a little bit.
All right, I'll slow down.
Thank you.
So again, as I'm sure you know, if humans make it and it goes into the water in a concentration that it can affect human health, it shouldn't be there, and every step possible should be taken to prevent it from going into the water. That includes criteria for carcinogens and for non-carcinogens, and it's applicable when the worst case scenario and pollution conditions occur at a particular point of evaluation. In other words, any kind of decision should be based on the worst possible confluence of events, the worst storm combined with the worst flooding, combined with the worst wind event. All of that together is how you should be evaluating what should happen here. In terms of the specific standards, for standard 2, which has to do with groundwater recharge, National Grid is not meeting the requirements of groundwater recharge and is using the excuse that the site is contaminated, so it can't fully comply. I'll be speaking about the use of the contaminated site as a reason for doing less instead of doing more in just a moment. Standard 3, National Grid doesn't address potential contaminants from storage of condensate. All of its applications state that it's going to store condensate on site. Doesn't address what's going to happen if there's a problem with that, or if it escapes, if there's a leak. Doesn't address the other hazardous chemicals that are in direct gas. Doesn't address runoff on the portion of the site that's not being worked on. There are also some concerns about standard 5 to do with fill in the floodplain. Because of the enormous amount of fill that National Grid is planning to put in the floodplain, National Grid should be required to meet standard 5, which assures no increase in frequency. I'm running out of time, so I want to say just a really quick word, which is that the laws are supposed to apply to everybody, but in this state, there's one law for the water near you if you're rich, and another law for the water near you if you're poor. And we need to be making sure that you apply those laws equally to everyone in this state.